Today, with the help of Pure JavaScript, we are going to build the web app. So this app will check your password strength. Let me show you the demo. I have given there 5 conditions. Whenever it meets any condition, the strength of your password will increase. And that strength of password is represented in form of progress bar, and also it is automatic. I mean, whenever you are removing any characters from the password, the strength of your password will decrease, and that is also represented in the form of progress bar. And finally, you can see there is change in the color in progress bar as well as the border around the box. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsar with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside the index.html file, if I type action design and hit that tab button, then you'll get this HTML5 boilerplate. Now let's give the title. For the title, I'm giving password strength checker. And now inside the body tag, let's create a div with class name password checker. And inside that div, I'm creating h1 heading. Let's give the heading password. And also I'm giving the br tag strength checker. And also let's create the div with class name input group. And inside that div, I'm creating input element with type text. For now, let's give the input type text, but later on we'll change it to password. And also for the id and placeholder, I'm giving password. Now just next to div with class name input group, let's create h5 heading. And inside that heading, I'm writing password strength. Let's save the file. Now if you're using VS Code, and if you have installed the extension called live server, then in the index.html file, if you right click, you'll get this option called open with live server. If you hit that option, it will open it in your default browser. And the use of this extension is that whenever there is any changes in the HTML file, it will automatically refresh your browser. Now let's create the style.css file. Just below the title tag, let's link that style.css file. In the style.css file, for the root pseudo class, I'm giving some color variables. So for the primary variable, I'm giving some kind of purple color. At the end, I'm giving 50, that means 50%, which is the alpha value that controls the transparency of that color. Similarly, let's create another variable, input vg. For that variable, I'm giving dark blue color. Also, let's create another variable, text color. And for that variable, I'm giving white color. Now for the universal selector, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, I'm giving margin 0 and padding 0, and also box sizing to border box. So now you can see we are removing that browser's default margin and padding. Okay, for the body tag, let's give the minimum height. I'm giving minimum height of 100 vh, and also let's give display flex, justify content to center. So that justify content to center will bring your content horizontally center, and let's give align items to center. So that align items center will bring your content vertically center. And also let's give the font. For the font weight, I'm giving 400. For the font size, I'm giving 1 rem. And for the font family, let's give sans serif. Similarly, I'm giving background image. For the URL, I'm giving background.jpg. You can see in the same folder, I do have image named background.jpg. If I save, I'm in the browser, you can see that image. And also, let's give background size to cover. Now, let's style the div with class name password checker. So for the class password checker, let's give the width of 50 vw. That means it will take the 50% of viewport's width. And I'm giving background color. For the background color, let's give that primary variable. So in the browser you can see. Now let's give the padding. For the padding, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's give the border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 1 rem. In the browser now you can see rounded corner and also the space around the box. I'm giving border. For the border width, let's give 0.1 rem. For the border style, I'm giving solid. For now, for the border color, I'm giving transparent, but later on with the help of JavaScript code, we'll change that dynamically. Okay, now let's copy that class password checker. So when you hover that password checker, let's give the transform. I'm giving scale. I'm giving scale value to 1.05. And in the browser now you can see when you hover, that box is scaling up, but there is no any smooth transition. So for the class password checker, let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I'm giving 0.4 second. For the timing function, let's give is in out. So now in the browser, when I hover the box, now you can see there is smooth transition. So let's give the cursor to pointer, so that when you hover guard, you will get that pointing hand icon. Now let's style the h1 heading. For the H1 heading, let's give the font. For the font width, I'm giving 800. For the font size, I'm giving 2 rem. For the font family, I'm giving sans serif. And also for the body tag, let's give the color. For the color, I'm giving that text color variable. And also for the H1 heading, let's give the letter spacing. For the letter spacing, I'm giving 0.1 rem. So you can see there is some space between the letters. And also I'm giving text transform to uppercase. Now for the D with class name input group, let's give the width of 100%. You can see for the class password checker, we have given the width 50 VW. So that 100% means it will occupy all viewport's width. And also I want to give some space between that heading and the input field. So for that, I'm giving margin top. Let's give 2 rem. So now you can see there is some space between the heading and the input element. Now let's style the input element with ID password. So for the input element with ID password, let's give the width of 100%, and also let's give padding. For the padding, I'm giving 1 rem. Let's give the background color. For the background color, I'm giving that input BG variable. Similarly, let's increase that font size. So let's give the font size of 1 rem. So when I type anything, okay, you can see that black color text. So for the color, let's give that text color variable. Now you can see that color is changing to white color. Similarly, let's remove that border. So in order to remove that border, I'm giving border none. I want to use icon inside that input field. For the icon, you could use like third-party libraries. Now in order to give that icon for the class input group, let's give the before pseudo element, and let's give the position of absolute. Let's duplicate this code and let's take it to that class input group, and instead of that absolute, let's give the position of relative. And for the class input group with before pseudo element, let's give the content. For the content, if I give /1f500tuple, so with the help of this code, you can get that icon. Actually, it's a lock emoji. Now let's give the left. For the left, I'm giving 1 rem. For the top, I'm giving 50%, but it is not exactly at the center of the input field. So I'm giving transform. For the transform, let's give the translate y -50%. In the browser, now you can see that icon is exactly at the center of that input field. Now for the input element with ID password, for the padding, we have given the 1 rem. Now let's change that padding value. For the top, right and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left, I'm giving padding of 2.8 rem. Now you can see there is proper space between the icon and the text inside that input field. But we want to display the password strength in progress bar. So in order to do that, in the index.html file, just below the h5 heading, let's create div with class name progress, and inside that div, let's create another div with class name bar. Now let's style this h5 heading and also all the other elements. Okay, so for the h5 heading, let's give the margin. For the margin, let's give for the top 3 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 0, and for the bottom, I'm giving 1.5 rem. Now let's style the div with class name progress. For the class progress, let's give the height of 0.4 rem. For the width, let's give 100%. And for the background color, let's give light gray color. And also let's give the border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 0.4 rem. And also let's duplicate that code and let's take it to the input element with ID password. And instead of that 0.4 rem, let's give 0.5 rem. Now you can see in the browser, rounded columns around the input element as well as light gray bar. Similarly, let's style the class bar. For the class bar, let's give the height of 100%. And also let's give the width. For now, for the width, I'm giving 25%. And also let's give the background color, and I'm giving background color red color. I'm giving border radius of inherit. You can see div with class name bar is the child of div with class name progress. So it will inherit the border radius of that class progress. That means we'll get the border radius of 0.4 rem. With the help of JavaScript code, we'll change that width value dynamically. So whenever there is any changes in the width, we want to give some smooth transition. So for that, I'm giving transition duration of 0.4 second. And also for the time function, let's give is in out. Now let's change that width to 75%. And for now, let's give that class bar's width to 0%. Let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. Now, in order to check the password strength, we need the JavaScript code. So let's create the script.js file. And let's link our JavaScript file just above the end of body tag. Let's create the script tag with source script.js file. Now inside this script.js file, let's create the constant variable password checker. And I'm assigning document.querySelector dot, we're selecting this div with class name password checker. So let's copy and let's paste that class. And also let's duplicate this code. Now instead of that password checker, let's give only the password. And also let's remove this code. And instead of that dot, let's give the hash. Because in the index.html file, you can see for the input element, we have given the ID password. So we are selecting that input element, okay? And also let's create another constant variable progress bar. And I'm assigning document.querySelector. So we are selecting div with class name bar. So in the input element, whenever I'm typing anything, I want to run the some event so that password variable represent the input element. So I want to listen to the key of event. So I'm writing dot on key of, I'm assigning arrow function. So inside the arrow function, I want to console.log the password value. So in the browser, if I press F12 key and if you go to the console tab, so in the console, you can see whenever I'm typing anything in the input element, all those values are displayed there, okay? Now, whenever you're typing anything in that input field, I wanna call the check password strength function. And along with that, I'm passing the password.value. But you can see we haven't created that function. So let's create that function, check password strength. So that function takes the argument. So let's take that password value as a password. And inside that function, let's create the variable strength. And for now, let's give 0. Now let's console.log that strength variable. So in the browser, now whenever I'm typing anything in the input field, you can see in the console 0 and U. So it's working perfectly. These are the 5 requirements, or you can say these are the 5 conditions. With the fulfillment of requirement, we'll increase that strength variable's value. So for the first condition, it's about the uppercase character. So let's give the condition. For the condition, let's give if, so that password, okay, if that password match. So we are giving the regular expression. So in order to give that regular expression, you have to give double forward slash. I'm giving small bracket and question mark is equal to period asterisk. I'm giving square bracket, and inside that square bracket, I'm giving capital A and capital G. So with the help of that square bracket, we are giving the range of capital character. With the help of this code, we are checking if that password matches all the uppercase character, okay? This expression can be written in different form. Instead of matching the password, you can use test. If the password matches or the condition is true, then we are increasing the strength value by 1, okay? So I'm writing strength plus plus. So that is strength plus plus means it's the strength is equal to strength plus 1. You can see in the browser, if I type other than the uppercase character, you will get that 0. But what if I give the uppercase character? Look at that, you are getting that 1, okay? Whenever that condition is true, the strength value will be increased by 1. Let's duplicate this code, and instead of that capital A to G, let's give small a to G, okay? So whenever this condition is true, once again, we're increasing that strength value by 1. Let's copy this code and let's paste it there. Now for the numerical characters, now instead of that small a to G, let's give 0 to 9, or you could give something like backward slash D. It means the same thing, okay? But if I give that range, it will be easier to understand, okay? So yeah, I'm giving the 0 to 9 range. Similarly, for the special characters, now instead of that 0 to 9, let's give all the special characters, something like backtick, exclamatory sign, add, hash, caret symbol. You can give all the special characters, okay? Now the next condition is that the password should be at least 9 characters. In order to check that condition, you could use something like if password.length greater or equal to 9. You could use something like this, but for all the condition, I'm using regular expression. So in order to check that at least 9 characters, now let's remove that range and also that asterisk. Instead, now let's give the curly bracket, and inside that I'm giving 9 comma. So that first value 9, that means the minimum, and if I give comma something like 20, that means that 20 is the maximum value. But for the user, I only give the freedom that he or she could give any number of character, but minimum there should be 9 characters. So for the maximum value, I'm not giving any maximum value. And let's comment that code. Now in the browser, you can see when I type all the lowercase, uppercase, number, and also some special symbol. In the console, you can see the password strength value. You can see at the end 5, so that 5 is the maximum strength of that password. We'll represent that strength in progress bar. So in order to do that, let's give the condition if strength is equal to 1. Then for the progress bar, let's give the CSS value. For that, I'm writing dot style dot CSS text is equal to backtick. In the keyboard just above the tab button, you'll get this symbol. So with the help of this template literals, it is easier to work with the string and the variable. So now let's try it width. But in the style CSS file, you can see for the class bar, initially for the width, we are giving 0%. And now let's try dollar curly bracket. And inside that, you could pass the variable. So I'm passing that strength variable. So for now, that strength is 1, and I'm giving slash 5, that is the number of conditions. Okay, we have there 5 conditions, so I'm giving that 5, and let's wrap it inside the small bracket, and I'm converting this value into 100%. So I'm writing asterisk 100. So we have there strength 1 divided by 5 into 100%, that gives the 20%. Instead of this calculation manually, you could give something like 20%, but I want to make it dynamic. So for that, I'm writing this code, and at the end, let's give percent. Now let's change that background red to onset. With the help of JavaScript code, we'll change that background color to red. Okay, so in the browser, if I type anything, you can see in the progress bar, that red bar that is rising. I think in this case, instead of using this if statement, it is better to use switch statement. For the switch, let's pass that strength variable, and for the case one, let's give that expression, and you need to give the break. Now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Let's give the case 2. Now whenever the strength value is 2, in that case, we'll change that background color to orange red. Similarly, let's select this code and let's duplicate it for 3 times, and let's change that case to 3, 4, 5. Now for the case 3, let's change that background color to gold. And also for the case 4, let's give background color to deep sky blue color. And for the final case, that is 5, let's give background color to lime. And in the browser, when I'm giving uppercase, the strength value increases by 1, and I'm giving the lowercase and the numeric value. So along with that, the progress bar is increasing, and also there is change in the color. So at the 100%, you can see that lime color, that means that is the green color. And also when I'm removing that password, the password strength is decreasing. So along with that, the progress bar is decreasing, and also there is change in color. But you can see I have removed everything, but in the progress bar, you can see that red color. So in order to prevent that, you can see initially we have the strength value of 0. So we need the case for that 0. So let's select this code and let's duplicate it, and let's create the case of 0. So whenever there is 0 strength, we'll change that background color to onset. Now I want to give you the challenge. So the challenge is that now I want you to change that border color around that box. So you can pause the video and you can try out. Okay, I do hope you have tried that challenge. Now let's see the solution. You can see I have already selected the DWIT class name password checker. So for the password checker, initially for the border, we have given the border color of transparent in the case 0. So now for the password checker, let's give the CSS value. For that, I'm writing password checker dot style dot border color. Remember that C is capital letter C. Okay, in the case 0, let's give border color of transparent. Let's duplicate this code and let's take it to the case 1, and let's change it to same red color. The process goes in the same way. Okay, so I'm speeding up the code. Now in the browser, you can see whenever there is increase in the strength of password, progress bar and also the border color of that box is changing. But if you have noticed that for the input element, we have given their type text, but we are talking about the password. So for the input type, let's give password. So when I type anything, you can see you would feel like you are typing the password. But let me tell you, if you have your own favorite color, or if you prefer the different color, now you just need to change the color variable's value. Okay, it's that simple. And also if you don't like that background image, you can change that. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.